So you've got two stems, I think we've got two stems in this now. So you've got allowance of two stems. Obviously this can be used in other time stage during the day as well. But we mainly want it for this these designs, so. And they're nice strong stems as well. White's quite dominant, so I'm actually making sure that I've got quite a bit of ink for stuff. I've actually got four white there, which makes it look like a square shape, so I'm actually going to add another one in. It's like a five. But because it's dominant on the outside edge, I need to actually make sure that I've got some, like the three primary colours, we put a Lizzie Actress in between those. So that's your profile here. Now 50 minutes I think is a very generous assessment time. So there is opportunities to think about how you can make your design distinctive. Wax felt lovely because of the shape. You've got jip. Now I would be careful if you use the jip not to overuse jip because it can make it look like a little blob. You tend to overuse it, so just subtle amounts. But I like the wax flower because you've got some nice budding sort of foliage bits first, which you could use on the outside edge. And then the more open ones, you can incorporate towards the focal area. This is where your dominating area is. And it's where you might have drawn to first. So your sort of buds placed on the edge, and the more open ones, like that would be more open towards the centre. And it's what we call recession. I'm recessing the material low down. And then what you'll notice I'm doing, I keep turning it as I'm making it to make sure that I don't forget all the sides, because that's sometimes what happens. You focus on one area, you forget about the other side. It's like a pattern, really. What you do one side, you're going to do the other. Make use of all your stem as well. You could put some fabric up.
Do you know, it really depends. Yeah, I tend to cover the handle a lot of the time. Just because for me, I don't like it. But I think a lot of people, a lot of us done. I think it all depends on, like, but that's where this way, like, distinctive use of materials and stuff comes in. I think when you're making stuff, it's up to you to look at it and think. Yeah,
it's not a mandatory requirement.
The best thing is to.
I think before it's quite tricky to do. You could get some of the fabric, organza fabric, and pull it up, and then here, like, do a wire. And then maybe a couple of little frou-frou, like little collar type thing go around. But you need to do that before, really. It's quite tricky otherwise, once you've got flowers in, because it's this bit that's hard to cover. Some people have used cord. Do you know cord? You start gluing it at the bottom, and then you just wrap it around and around, and then you put glue here and wrap that round, and then it ends at the top. That sort of cord. I don't think you've seen it before. That's quite in use quite a bit.
I would say it's quite tricky. To do the bottom like you hit me. So, I mean, it's not mandatory for this one. I mean,
but 50 minutes is quite a lot, but it's worth
it. Have a practice on it without it. See what you can do, like with Louise, put some bear grass, like with some cage and stuff. And then see if you find you're doing it with enough time, then try doing it.
We'll definitely do a ribbon handle when we do the wide version, because that has to happen. But it's quite good to try it, because it's quite a challenge. So, we're going to incorporate. these hyacinth pips. These are little florets of the hyacinth. I'm not going to put a whole stem in. A, because it's quite thick, and also it doesn't really look nice. Now, you use a 46, I think it's actually a 56 wire, or a 46. And I took the stem off, and I'm going to do an internal... do it with silver wire as well, but this is quite a good one for one coming out. Put a tiny little hook on the end, and bring it down. This is what we call a ribbed unit. A ribbed, R-I-B-B-E-D. And you're going to bring a few stems. Some people put a bead as well on the end here, and then when they pulled it in, they've actually got a little bead sitting in the hyacinth. That's quite pretty. So I've just got things, a little bit of paraffin. Now with hyacinths, there's a lot of moisture in here, so it's very difficult just to cover that bit of stem. So I go around that bulbous part several times first, then I work down the stem a little bit. It's really just to keep security and moisture in. I'm not going to go all the way down because I'm actually going to replace that. What colour is it? Colour? They actually class this as a bloom hyacinth. Delphine, I think they call it.
A lot of flowers in forestry that are purple classed as like blue.
Yeah, it's one of those. Bloom, really, the only thing you get in blue is to dye it. If you wanted to put a couple of ribbed units in your design, you could do singles. So you could wire, if I show you how to put a bead in, so you choose whatever bead you want. It gives you a little bit of sparkle as well. So you could do singles, and actually when we do our other wiring, you can use this technique. You need to use them towards the centre. Or there as well. You could do bare grass, just showing you a few ideas. You could thread beads onto the bare grass. That's what I mean. Remember, it's 50 minutes. It's a lot of time. And, you know, if the time's there, use it. Don't feel, and you can get better grades rather than just rushing it and actually, you know, missing something. So you can thread your bare grass. You don't need to wire like, brilliantly with the bare grass because it's in foam. So you can cut, find one end. Outside edge ones as well. There's loads of things you could do. But then it's very important at the end that you cover, even things like ruscus is nice, if you want to cover a bit of ruscus. But you need to go back and check that all your oasis is covered. Okay, so I would go back to my gaps and just check that my foam's covered. So maybe I'll put a bit of jip in, my frontage as well. Even the underside, maybe this looks tiny as well. You've got all that loads of oasis showing, but if you see there's quite a bit of oasis still showing in here, so that would have to be go back and covered. And that sort of asparagus is quite probably quite good for doing that as well. So this is where I'd hold it to eye level and just keep turning it and checking it as well. But yeah, jip, you have to be careful jip because you can have a tendency to put too much in. Well, that's what I was going to say to yourselves, actually. I mean, how do you think? It's difficult, because obviously... It does depend, yeah. It's quite small.
Yeah. They can really vary. I think I would probably say £20 to £25, I think, is...
little hand tires, yeah, so only do it like 15 times a day, so you don't want to be too.
I mean, you're not using much floral material
in it.
If you look at what Louise has done, there's not much floral material in it at all, and it is quite quick to do. So depending, obviously, on how much you charge on your labour cost, it shouldn't really... You could probably do 15 to 25, anywhere between then, depending on what flowers you're using.